Right now, you, Thor, you're the strongest deadlifter in the world. I full-heartedly believe it. And I believe that you can pull 501. I believe it. I just don't think you should right now. I don't think you should.
All right, what's going on, you guys? Nick here with Nick Strength and Power. I hope you guys have had a great weekend, a great holiday weekend if you guys celebrate Easter, or just a great weekend with your family or your loved ones at home. Like I said, I know it's been a kind of a boring past month or so. We're all stuck at home, but I hope you guys are all at least safe and healthy, and at least being entertained right now watching this YouTube video. So please give this video a thumbs up if it is helping your quarantine go a little bit better. Now, I've got several interesting stories for you guys today, but I wanted to start out with a story about Sean Roden. So as you guys know, Sean Roden was not able to do the 2019 Mr. Olympia due to the legal circumstances surrounding Sean at the time and still surrounding Sean. But there's the possibility still that Sean could compete one day again. And hopefully, that would be in 2020. Hopefully, we see a lot of bodybuilders able to compete in 2020. Hopefully the Olympia still goes on as scheduled. Hopefully they're able to hold Athleticon in October after the Olympia as scheduled. And hopefully this worldwide situation that we can't mention is going to be resolved or over or resolved to a point where certain events like this can still take place. Whatever it is they need to figure out for that to happen, hopefully it's able to happen. If you had told me a couple months ago that the Arnold Classic Expo was going to be completely canceled, I would have never believed you. So if you would tell me right now the Olympia was going to be canceled, I wouldn't be surprised, but who knows? It might still go on as scheduled. I know that they are definitely pushing for it to go on as scheduled, and they want it to happen, and they're still promoting it as if it's going to go on as scheduled. But anyway, back to the Sean Roden story. So Sean Roden did an interview, a rare interview. You don't see too many interviews with Sean on Jay Cutler TV's YouTube channel. I wanted to show you guys this direct quote referencing the possibility of a Sean Roden comeback to the bodybuilding stage, which again is hinging entirely upon the outcome of the legal issues that Sean is facing. So this is what Sean had to say about the prospect of a comeback. "Can I? 100%, Roden said. I felt as if 2018 was a great year, and I started prep at 258. Right now I'm at 286, and there's a different kind of fire. I'm taking a different approach. I'm doing things that I've never done before. I'm deadlifting. I'm doing more free weights and more dumbbells. I never deadlift or heavy barbell rows or rack pulls. This year has been dedicated to training like I've never done before, and without a doubt, this is not being cocky. This is not being arrogant. Being on stage in 2020, I don't care who's there. It doesn't matter who shows up. I'm not spending my days seeing who's qualified or who looks what, because I know that the best version of Sean has not been seen yet." And again, this is in reference to a 2020 return, which I'm sure all of us would want to see from Sean Roden. Again, that is assuming things work out positively with his legal issues, but I think we need some exciting bodybuilding stories when it comes to Olympia time and the shows that follow the Olympia or that might precede the Olympia based on when they get rescheduled. I think we're going to be looking at an interesting fall of 2020 for bodybuilding if some of these things are able to happen, some of these shows are rescheduled and able to happen. And again, at this point, who knows? I mean, the Arnold Classic was scheduled to happen as planned up until like a day or two before the competition when all these announcements were made about all the cancellations. So as much as I want to see Sean Roden come back in 2020, I want to see bodybuilding come back in 2020 even more so than I want to see Sean. Now, speaking of bodybuilding in 2020, there was a big show coming up in May. It was going to be at the end of May, the California State, better known as the Cal Pro, the Cali Pro. It was canceled, but it has now been rescheduled for just 1 month later. On June 27th is the new rescheduled date, June 27th, 2020, for the Cali Pro. This is an Olympia qualifier. And the reason why we want to take a look at shows like this is because, again, the lineup for the 2020 Mr. Olympia, as far as qualified competitors go, is not that deep. So there's still a lot of big-name pros that need to compete and need to qualify to even be at the 2020 Mr. Olympia. So shows like the Cali Pro are the shows that we need to be paying attention to. When they get rescheduled, these are the shows that we could see a lot of big names jump in. Some of the guys that have been staying quiet, that have maybe been sticking to their diets and sticking to a prep and waiting for the right show to come along, while they're in their quarantine. Like I said, I'll throw some names out there. Big Ramy, Steve Kuklos, Sergio Oliva Jr. These are big name guys. Patrick Moore. These are guys that have not yet officially qualified for the Olympia. You could see them jump in one of these rescheduled shows in an attempt to win that show and maybe possibly thinking there's not going to be any other big names because of all these circumstances going on. So when these pro qualifiers get rescheduled, you could see a big name guy jump in there thinking he's going to win the show because no one else is going to do it, and he's going to nab that Olympia qualification. So right now, I believe this rescheduled Cali Pro on June 27th is the nearest pro show that we have that's going to be an Olympia qualifier. I believe the New York Pro was rescheduled for later in the fall, but the only big summer show that I'm aware of right now that's the nearest to us at this point is this Cali Pro rescheduled for June 27th. And hopefully that is a good date that they picked and they're able to hold it at that date, at that time. Again, that's like 2.5 months away. So at this point, you know, the rate that things have been changing, anything could happen in the next 2.5 months. So I guess we'll see what happens. But I'm certainly hoping that the Cali Pro is something that's able to go on as scheduled. And again, to all you pros out there, if you haven't qualified for the Olympia, that gives you, almost 10 weeks. If you kind of fell off your prep a little bit, it gives you almost 10 weeks to prep for that Cali Pro. If you want to nab that Olympia qualification, who knows who's going to show up. So now that being said, with not much bodybuilding news going on right now, let's talk about Strongman yet again and some new developments in the Eddie Hall, Halfdor Bjornsson situation, which in my opinion is one of the most exciting things we have going on right now. That 501 kilogram deadlift attempt is going to be happening in the beginning of May, May 2nd, 2020. It's going to be live streamed. And I honestly just can't wait to watch it just based on all the controversy that this has stirred up. I love it. I think it's interesting. I think we need this because I, like most of you guys, I'm going stir crazy in my house. So if you've been living under a rock, Eddie Hall versus Halfdor Bjornsson. Eddie Hall currently holds the deadlift world record, which he set at Giants Live, where he deadlifted 500 kilograms. Halfdor Bjornsson is attempting to break Eddie Hall's record. That is the big advertisement of this event, and hold the new deadlift world record at 501 kilograms, which he will be attempting in his home gym in Iceland due to the worldwide circumstances right now. He was originally going to go over to the Middle East, perform this deadlift in a competition, and then count it as a world record. So, ever since this was announced, Eddie Hall and Halfdor have been having a tremendous back and forth between Eddie saying he doesn't trust Halfdor and his team. He does not trust the lift if Halfdor does get the 501 kilograms in his home gym. Eddie said he would not count that as a world record. He also goes on to say that he does not believe that should be done, that a world record should be set outside of competition. Now, Halfdor obviously fired back at Eddie Hall, saying he didn't deserve to win the 2017 World's Strongest Man and that he was robbed. Halfdor was robbed. There's all this back and forth. And basically, the entire strongman world has started to weigh in on this situation. And their thoughts, mostly on a world record in strongman being set outside of a competition like Thor is doing in his gym. And honestly, the general consensus here seems to be that most other strongman competitors and winners and World's Strongest Man champions all feel as though a world record should be set in a competition. Now, Brian Shaw basically said this. Eddie has been saying this. Most recently, a multiple-time World's Strongest Man winner, Zydrunas Zavickas, Big Z, posted a video on his YouTube channel weighing in on it. And he gave a unique perspective talking about how there's all these different strongman federations and how world records are set in all these different federations. How you've got World's Strongest Man, you've got Giants Live, you've got World's Ultimate Strongman, you've got the Arnold Classic. You've got all these different places that set their own rules as far as world records go, because obviously there's so many lifts and so many implements in strongman. So he basically says it's up to the individual federation to do things how they want and dictate how they want that world record to go about being set. So essentially what he says here is if Hafthor wants to do this, he does say, though, that he thinks it should be done in competition. He thinks that's the better way for it to be done. But he says, you know, if Hafthor wants to do this and set this record under the world's ultimate strongman rules, if they want to consider that a world record, that's fine. But he said if he wants to beat Eddie Hall's record, he should have to compete in a competition, specifically, ideally, in a Giants Live deadlift competition, like where Eddie broke the record, following that federation's rules to break that federation's record. Because strongman, it's kind of weird the way things work and the way these records work and the way these federations have different rules. But effectively, I would say Big Z overall took Eddie's side on this argument, saying that Eddie's record should not be broken in another federation under different rules than when Eddie broke the record. So if they want to count it, is basically what Big Z said. If this federation, World's Ultimate Strongman, wants to count it as a world record, fine. But in his mind, it doesn't beat Eddie Hall unless the record is beaten, unless Eddie's record is beaten under the same circumstances that Eddie set that record in the first place. Because let's be honest, the whole advertisement and the whole selling point for this 501 attempt is the fact that it's 1 kilogram more than Eddie's record. So in reality, while it is going for the all-time world record, the reality is the whole point of this is to beat Eddie's record by 1 kilogram. That's the entire point of the 501 kg thing. So Big Z essentially says, if you want to beat Eddie's record, do it in competition under the same circumstances that Eddie set it, and that is the only way that should be considered legitimate. Now, in addition to Zydrunas Zafikas, Robert Oberst also made a video about the Hafthor versus Eddie situation, and he actually made a pretty bold opinion in his video. He actually goes as far to say, as Thor, I know you're watching this. I believe you are the strongest deadlifter in the world right now. I believe you can pull 501 kilograms. I believe you're the only person that can do that right now. But he says, I don't think you should. I don't think you should do it right now. I think you should wait until the time is right and it can be counted in competition as an official world record. And other deadlifters have the opportunity to step up to the plate and also attempt it. Because in Robert's video, he talks about his American log press world record, and he talks about how he feels a log press record is legitimate when other big-name guys like Eddie Hall and Brian Shaw and these big-name guys also attempt the exact same log, the exact same lift at the exact same competition, and they all fail, and you get it, and you set that record. That, in his mind, is what legitimizes the competition aspect of strongman and the record-setting aspect of strongman. Is it's not just what you can do in the gym. It's what you can do on the same day against other people that can't do that, that tried to do it and can't do it. So let me know in the comment section below who you tend to agree with here, whether it's Eddie or Hafthor or Brian or Big Z or Robert Oberst. Let me know where you're landing on this 501 kilogram deadlift debate. And I'm going to end this video with a video from my buddy, The Kid Plot, on Instagram. He put together this great quarantine video of all these different bodybuilders and famous influencers doing the Don't Rush Challenge. So shout out to The Kid Plot. I'm going to roll that video for you guys at the end of this video because I thought it was kind of a positive, uplifting, entertaining, and funny video. So kudos to him for putting that together. I think it was pretty good. So that's going to wrap it up for the video, guys. I hope you did enjoy it. Please subscribe to this channel if you have not subscribed already. Smash that thumbs up button. And as always, Nick Strength and Power, signing out.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like I go crunch, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust. White rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the trash, man it's so tough.
Alright yo, put the belly on the body, make a clutch. Seen her watch, now she wanna give crutch. Boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod. Man, a real life sugar gal, and my forget what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top. Switching lanes the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus. Maybe this a Moncler sweater, diesel denim. Buy another one, my pockets fat like heather. Neck froze like I don't know no better. Benzo truck, white seats and they leather. Go broke never, on my grind. She make it clap like I'm Busta Rhymes. I got the juice, the sauce and all them things. I blammed her twice a night with all my bling. Big Benz, I drive, I brought that ting. Any girl you want, they were my ting.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. I got good country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, quite wrong. Fizzy pop, where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the knife, man it's so tough. Flood my eyes, make a whole blush. Back of the tour bus, getting cool up. D-square, got them de-stressed. Got a hand wash, new racks with the old Nikes in the shoebox. Keep my stripes, no cuss. Pull up in a new plate, then she might just. She went trying to move bait when her eyes locked. New tints on her coupe, that's a head loss. Off my whites, right my wrongs. Gucci my mum, why you to do your thumbs? Count my sums, this is gonna get long. Love my green, I'm trying to get strong. Trying to get on, where I'm from, it's on. Yes, man don't take no dumb threats. They see funds, they hop fence. We been up, not up, next. Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. I can go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, quite wrong. Fizzy pop, where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the knife, man it's so tough.
And introduce him, the one and only. Big chop, no clutch, wrist rolls, don't touch. French Siri, I'm so drunk. Cause I can't drink and drive, where's my chauffeur? Find the whip car, whip the cold car. I really hold this time I work, I don't flossy. I was in the works, now my pen outside the top. Shay said they're best friends, I bet they both fuck. As they both cost, cause they said I sold drugs. And when you're down, ain't nobody around. What's to come back when you blow up? I forgot my jacket, but my heated seats help me warm up. Fast train to Inverary, I used to go up. It's ironic, I just sold out my show in Scotland. Used to say I wanna put Tottenham on a map, but one day I'ma change the map in Tottenham.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. I got good country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, quite wrong. Fizzy pop, where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the knife, man it's so tough. Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. I can go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, quite wrong. Fizzy pop, where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the knife, man it's so tough.
And introduce him, the one and only. Big chop, no clutch, wrist rolls, don't touch. French Siri, I'm so drunk. Cause I can't drink and drive, where's my chauffeur? Find the whip car, whip the cold car. I really hold this time I work, I don't flossy. I was in the works, now my pen outside the top. Shay said they're best friends, I bet they both fuck. As they both cost, cause they said I sold drugs. And when you're down, ain't nobody around. Watch the comeback, when you blow up. I forgot my jacket, but my heated seats help me warm up. Fast train to Inverary, I used to go up. It's ironic, I just sold out my show in Scotland. Used to say I wanna put Tottenham on a map, but one day I'ma change the map in Tottenham.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. I got good country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust,